Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. We are now about to start the special session that we have at Jalsa Salana on second and third day, where we have respected guests from the United Kingdom and from other countries of the world who come and address us. We will start this session with the recitation of the Holy Quran, and I request Hafiz Mashood Sahib to come and recite a portion of the Holy Quran, please.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا.
Now, for the Jalsa Salana, we have received a large number of messages of goodwill from various parliamentarians, and we will start with a video message that we have received from Tim Farron, Member of Parliament, who is now the new leader of Liberal Democrats. Tim Farron is a Member of Parliament for West Moorfield and Lonsdale, and is now, as I mentioned, the leader of Liberal Democratic Party. So I would request you to please kindly listen to his message.
Very warm greetings from myself, Tim Farron, on behalf of the Liberal Democrat Party across the United Kingdom on the 49th convention of the Ahmadiyyan Muslim community in the United Kingdom. A community that we're very proud of, that shares our commitment to moderation, to peace, to tolerance. You will know if you've studied your history of the Liberal Party, that the Liberal Party's entire coming into being in the 19th century was to promote and to defend religious tolerance, and we do so today as well. We're proud to stand alongside you because you do just the same. In a society where human rights are often under threat, where moderation is under threat, where tolerance is often under threat, it's so important that people like yourselves, myself, and others like us stand together and fight for a Britain that is tolerant, decent, outward-looking, generous-spirited, moderate, peaceful, and puts human rights at the centre of everything, including and especially the rights of those people who wish to practice their religion in accordance with their faith. That's what I would want for myself, it's what I want for you as well. So I hope to be with you on another occasion. I'm sorry I can only be here through the gift of video technology today, but I'm with you in spirit, if you like. I want to be with you. Sorry that I'm not there, but I'm absolutely alongside you, and we as the Liberal Democrats will be working with you in the years to come, if you'll have us, as fellow travellers in fighting for peace and for human rights in this country and beyond. Have a great convention.
Thank you very much, Jazakallah. Now, our first speaker this afternoon is Councillor Mrs. Pat Frost, who is the Mayor of Farnham. Pat has been active in local politics for more than 30 years. She plays a very active part in the local community and is the only Farnham member to be a town, borough, and county councillor. Councillor Mrs. Pat Frost has lived in Farnham for 40 years. It gives me great pleasure to welcome her to come and say a few words.
Thank you. Your Holiness, National President, honoured guests and delegates, it's an absolute joy to be back with you again. This is my third visit to Jalsa Salana, and I have enjoyed every single one of them. What is it about Jalsa Salana that I enjoy so much? I'm drawn to the banner at the end of the hall, which says, love for all, hatred for none. And with all the things one reads in the press and hears on the media, when you come here, you feel love. And I think that is very important. And what you do and the charities you support and the way that your young people help with this great event is fantastic. And I salute you all for getting involved and for having this mantra, which is the love for all, hatred for none. I would like to thank you for all the support you do for your charities, because I have benefited from that support. For my charity, when I first came here as Mayor of Waverley in 2009, and that was when you were at Tilford, actually in Waverley. Keep up the good work. With the guests that are here today, if they've only been for the first time, I would urge them to come back to learn more about your community, as indeed I have done, and to be grateful for the invitation that I received. So thank you all very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Councillor Pat Frost. Our next respected speaker this afternoon is the Mayor of Alton, Councillor Mrs. Pam Jones, and she is the mayor of the borough in which the Jalsa Salana takes place, and they have always cooperated with us, and I'm very grateful to the mayor and her team, and I would like to thank her for her continued support and invite her to come and say a few words.
Your Holiness, National President, honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to be here today and I bring you greetings from the people of Alton. We are bombarded daily by the media with news of a world that is constantly being torn apart by wars fueled by greed and religious intolerance. So it has been a humbling experience to learn of all the work you are doing in support of your aim, love for all, hatred for none. As well as being a member of Alton Town Council, I have worked as a school teacher, and I am heartened to read about the high value you place on education for all your young people, both boys and girls. The Amada Youth Organisation, MKA, continues to go from strength to strength, and I was delighted to learn of their many achievements. MKA UK is well respected and continues to work with many British charities. Their work promoting peace and tolerance in society is a credit to your whole community. These young people hold the future in their hands and will carry on your good work for the next 100 years and beyond. We were all young once and had our dreams and ambitions. Whether we achieved them though depended on the support we received from our families and the community in which we lived. I would like to take this opportunity to speak to all your young people directly. I wish them well in the future and thank all their families and their teachers for the love and support they give them, even though the young people sometimes think we are much too old to understand. Thank you for inviting me to speak today. I wish you all good health and happiness and a blessed Jalsa Salana 2015. May peace be with us all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Councillor Pam Jones. Our next speaker is Mayor of Rushmore. Now, Rushmore is the area where we held our Jalsa Salana before we moved to Hadikat al-Mehdi. And Councillor Martin Tennant, who is the Mayor of Rushmore, encompasses Farnborough and Aldershot. It gives me great pleasure to welcome him to Jalsa Salana and invite him to come and say a few words.
Thank you, Your Holiness, honoured guests and delegates. It is a great pleasure and an honour to be here today, and I'm heartened to hear such inclusive views, and I feel more oxygen needs to be given to them. I'm saddened by the persecution that you've faced historically, and I am sure that this sadness will be replaced with hope for the future. May I wish you all the well.
Thank you very much. Our next speaker is also a mayor, Councillor Nasser Malik, who is the mayor of the borough of Hounslow. Nasser's ambitions are to bring communities together and engage with people young and old. He wants Hounslow to be a beacon borough for community cohesion. He's a man of principle and a strong supporter of the Jamaat. It gives me great pleasure to welcome him and ask him to say a few words.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. It is my pleasure to be here representing the London Borough of Hounslow as a mayor. Traditionally, MDA Muslim community have engaged with our borough quite closely, and all my predecessors have actually attended most of the time these events. It is good to see the work this community does. It is to promote the peace, love, and try work hard for the people who cannot help themselves and the charitable work you do. And I think all of us have a moral duty to be supportive of any good cause, and particularly when it's coming from the communities who actually get together in thousands on this occasion, on the 49th, I believe it is, the Jalsa, which is a great, great honor to be here. And I only say the tolerance has to be from all sides. And there is a saying that you must not tolerate so much that you start tolerating the intolerance. So all intolerances are in every religion, in every communities. We all need to work together that intolerance people do not prevail. It's the people who tolerate and work together regardless of what they believe in. So I am very grateful for inviting, and I wish you the very best. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Councillor Nas. Our next speaker comes all the way from Japan. Yoshio Iwamura is serving as the president of the Kobe Biblical Theological Seminary and is the pastor of Kobe International Christ Church. He's also a guest lecturer at various colleges and has traveled from Japan to join us here today. It gives me great pleasure to invite him to our Jalsa Salana and request him to say a few words.
His Holiness Fuzuru, participants of Jalsa Salan, United Kingdom. Assalam o alaikum. I would like to express congratulations for this conference as a representative on our behalf. I will share the message that is a great honor for us to join such a beautiful, inspiring, and educational assembly. And we immediately realize an international atmosphere mutual understanding and friendship such as one family. In spite of different languages, the color of skin, and nationality. This is why I was allowed to attend this holy convention. 4 years have passed since the great tsunami or earthquake assaulted the northern part of Japan. As you know, God guided a good relationship between our volunteer activities and Ahamadir of Japan. Therefore, I was touched with true love of Ahamadir toward the Japanese who were suffered from the deaths, casualties, and loneliness because of lost their family members, houses, and friends. The head of Ahamadir Japan, Anis Ahmad Nadim, and I became friends to cope with the welfare, affection, rescue aspect to there from that time on. I am so glad to hear that God has a plan to establish the Ahmadiyya Mosque, which is the largest throughout Japan, in November this year. It is a great natural for me to gather the opening ceremony of the first Ahmadiyya Mosque and with share this expecting opportunity to all the people who love God. So welcome to Nagoya, Japan this November, and we are looking forward to see you again. Brothers and sisters, as you know, it's 70 years since the Second World War II ended. Could you please pray for Japan, seek for peace? I was moved to participate this spiritual meeting because I was encouraged by the behavior of younger generation, especially boys, who share the water among the audience with smiling faces. Not no obligation from their parents. I would like to express how kind, generous, and sincere attitudes. I shall never forget your hospitality as long as I live. Thank you very much. Habat Mizra Ahmad, the Caliph and worldwide head of this conference. Zin Dabad.
Thank you very much. Our next respected speaker is Alhaj Muri Gabade Basari, who is the chairman of MI Television in Nigeria. MI Television is one of the largest TV channels in Nigeria and plays live MTA programs, especially of Hazuri Akhtar's speeches. Alhaj Muri is very supportive of the Jamaat. I thank him for joining us here today at the Jalsa Salana, and I welcome him and invite him to come and say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum, Jamaat.
Wa alaikum assalam.
My purpose of coming is not to give lectures or to give. I only come here to thank the Amir General and Messiah, who is the organizer of this program, which we have been benefiting from it, especially Ahmadiyya Jamaat. Since about a century ago, it has been present in Nigeria. That is my purpose of coming to thank them, to continue the peace message they always deliver to the world. May God bless them. Amen.
Our next respected speaker is the Honourable Roy Arora, Mayor of the Royal Borough of Kingston upon Thames. Councillor Roy Arora was installed as the Mayor of Kingston in May 2015. Sorry? I've just been advised that Roy has not arrived yet. Our next respected speaker is Mr. Jacques Butholi, who is the representative of the Bishop of French Guiana. He's serving as a director of the court and a judge, and he's also a diplomat for the Council of Haiti. He's a very close friend of the Jamaat, and I invite him to address the Jalsa Salana. He will be addressing us in French, and we will get translation from our missionary from French Guiana, Mohammed Bisharat Sahib.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah al-barakat. Je salue avec honneur le calife Sa Sainteté Mirza Massoud Ahmed V. Tous les imams missionnaires venus des quatre coins du monde aussi. Moi, Jacques Berthold, français, chrétien, né en Tunisie, terre d'islam, je bénis mon vécu et mon adolescence ou par l'enseignement de l'arabe que j'ai accepté de recevoir de ce pays natal, m'a permis ainsi de côtoyer l'islam et mieux comprendre la fraternité des hommes. Je mesure l'importance de cette rencontre ici et je m'engage avec tous, avec conviction, pour que l'on apporte aide et joie au peuple de ce monde. Je reste convaincu que les hommes sont égaux devant leurs obligations, leurs droits et leurs devoirs, mais ils doivent forger leur destin à chaque pas de leur vie. L'humanité doit toujours être grandissante pour l'autre et aussi face à l'autre, pour que chacun d'entre nous soit un travail permanent sur soi qui doit être fait pour conserver l'absolue nécessité d'améliorer sa capacité de recevoir l'autre. Je voudrais aussi vous apporter mon témoignage dans le pays où je vis, la Guyane française. L'implantation de la mission musulmane Ahmadiyya, conduite avec lui par l'islam Sadiq Ahmed Manawar Monana et l'imam Mohamed Bacharat, ici à mes côtés, que je salue encore avec grande fraternité. Dans le quartier où il réside, cette communauté Ahmadiyya rayonne par sa tolérance, sa charité et la dignité qu'ils imposent avec naturel et bon sens depuis alors qu'ils sont si peu de temps ici en Guyane. Votre Sainteté, donnez-moi la possibilité aujourd'hui et publiquement devant vous tous, ici rassemblés, leur apporter la fraternelle reconnaissance de la construction qu'ils mettent en place pas à pas dans cette société guyanaise, fait d'espoir et d'avenir, dans la complexe sociologie qui la compose des hommes et des femmes. Je les salue à nouveau et je terminerai en vous apportant à vous tous réunis ici, et notamment aux musulmans Ahmadiyya, et à Hazrat Mirza Massoud Ahmed, mon grand salut fraternel, fait d'amitié profonde et de charité. Bassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Amour pour tous, haine pour personne. Dieu est grand.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now I'd request Bisharat Sahib to come and please give a brief summary, please.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. فرماتے ہیں میں سب سے پہلے حضرت خلیفۃ المسیح الخامس ایدہ اللہ تعالیٰ بن نصر العزیز کی خدمت میں سلامتی کا پیغام پیش کرتا ہوں. میرا نام ژاک بیختول ہے. میں فرینچ اور عیسائی مذہب سے تعلق رکھتا ہوں. میری پیدائش ایک اسلامی ملک میں ہوئی، یعنی ٹونیشیا میں. وہاں گزارے ہوئے وقت نے اسلام کی حقیقی اور اصل تعلیم سے مجھے آگاہ کیا۔ میرا آج یہاں آپ لوگوں کے درمیان ہونا میرے لیے قابل فخر بات ہے۔ آج میں آپ سب کے سامنے فرینڈ گیانا میں جماعت احمدیہ کی خدمات کی گواہی پیش کرنا چاہتا ہوں۔ باوجود اس کے کہ کم وقت ہوا ہے آپ کی جماعت کو وہاں قائم ہوئے، لیکن حضور آپ کی جماعت کی رواداری اور خدمت خلق ہمارے ملک کے لیے نمونہ کے طور پر ہے۔ آخر میں تمام حاضرین جلسہ اور خاص طور پر حضور کی خدمت میں محبت بھرا سلام پیش کرتا ہوں۔ جزاک اللہ۔
جزاک اللہ۔ Our next respected speaker is Mehta Khilaf Wasru, who is from the island of Kosseri in the federal state of Micronesia. Mr. Mehta has served as the mayor of Milam for 11 years and is now retired. He has recently accepted Ahmadiyyat, and I welcome him to our Jalsa Salana and request him to come and say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum. In the name of God, the gracious, the merciful. Greeting to all of you, our guests, peace and blessing of Allah be upon you all. I bring greetings, love, and of Lingbo from Kosai, and one of the four states of the federal states of Micronesia we commonly call Hepesim. The island of Kosai is located in the most eastern island of the Caroline Hepesim. I am extremely grateful from the opportunity enlisted to me, inviting me to appear before you, which is a very rare occasion in any of us in the parts of the world. I would like to brief you with a short background of myself. I came from a family of 10, including my parents. Both of my parents have passed away, along with the sister and our youngest brother, leaving of 6 of us alive today. Our family is originally from the congregation sect of Christianity, the first religion to come to Kosai back in 1852. Presently, my oldest sister is a deaconess, and my oldest brother is a minister of the church, and my youngest brother is a deacon in a respective congregational church. As for me, I worked for Kosai State Government for 12 years, and local government for another 11 years as a mayor of Malim, one of the four municipalities in Kosai. I am a new member of Ahmadi Muslim Jamaat, and I found Jamaat to be very helpful and cooperative in teaching us peace, justice, nonviolence, and human rights. Learning about 6 fundamentals of the faith in reading books of Jamaat, such as absolute justice, kindness and kingship, as well how to be free from sin, I have inspired me greatly and really helped me to change my life. In this day, in early days of the Jamaat in Kosai, we have found ourselves facing various struggle in exercise our right to practice our Islamic faith. The governor passed an executive order to his director banning government service to Muslims, such as program on the state radio broadcast. He has forgotten that everyone has the right to access public service. Even the local taxi service refused to give right to anyone who is Muslim. By the grace of Allah, our missionaries did not give up in their prayers. Instead, they have spent even more time in religious study classes from Monday to Sunday every week. And above all, it is the prayer of our beloved Azur that has given us the strength to have courage inside, accept, become parts of the beautiful Samad. I believe there is an urgent need to recognize the one true God, who is our creator and is the only one true path for our survival of the mankind. Before I end my short remark before you today, I would like to take this opportunity to say Jazakallah, and in our vernacular, thank you very much. Kulomallam.
Thank you very much. Our next respected speaker has come all the way from Croatia. Mr. Pendek Drazen is a member of the Croatian Parliament. Mr. Pendek sits on the Judiciary and Legislative Committee and the Regional Development and European Funding Committee. He is a very good friend of the Jamaat, and it gives me great pleasure to invite him and ask him to say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum. His Holiness Mirza Masroor Ahmad and respected participants, my name is Draženko Pandek, and being a member of a Croatian National Parliament, I bring good wishes to all of you from Croatia. Along with me, there are also 25 Croatians who are participating in this event. Participation of such a large group itself speaks how open-minded Croatians are. Thank you very much for your great hospitality. We feel really privileged to be here. We are treated with great kindness and feel very welcome. Thank you from my heart. We will remember this event with joy. I was myself introduced to Ahmadi Muslim community this year at an event which was organized at Zagreb Cultural Center. Later, I also participated in a humanitarian program in which eyeglasses were donated, distributed among children of Down syndrome. The slogan of Ahmadiyya, love for all and hatred for none, is a unique slogan which can be followed really by all. The efforts done by the Supreme Head of the community to achieve global peace are really praiseworthy. Therefore, today I endorsed International Human Rights Committee report on discrimination of the Ahmadi community. Serving the humanity without discrimination on the basis of religion, race, color, or ethnicity, in fact, opened the ways for better introduction of different movements. So, my humble suggestion will be that along with religious activities, it will be extremely fruitful in Ahmadiyya through Humanity First can pay more attention on various welfare projects in Croatia and for Croatian people also. Myself and my party, which is currently running the government, can extend all possible assistance in this regard. Again, thank you very much for everything.
Thank you very much. Our next respected speaker is Honorable Patrick Jason, who is the Minister of Education and Youth and Sports in Belize. He's also the regional leader within the United Democratic Party. He's an academic by profession and has served as teacher and vice principal at the Anglican Cathedral College in Belize. Honorable Patrick Jason is a very good friend of the Jamaat. I welcome him to our Jalsa Salana and invite him to come and say a few words.
Peace of Almighty God be with you all. I bring you greetings from across the Atlantic, from the tiny nation state of beautiful Belize, the Caribbean jewel in the heart of Central America. I present salutations on behalf of our Prime Minister, the Right Honorable Dean Oliver Barrow, and his cabinet, of which I am pleased to serve as his Minister of Education, Youth, and Sports. After learning of the ideals of the Ahmadiyya Muslim and of the ideals of His Holiness the Promised Messiah, I was pleased to accept this invitation to Jalsa Salana 2015. I wish that the message be conveyed to His Holiness, that we take the opportunity to thank him on behalf of the government and people of Belize for his and the Ahmadiyya Muslim movement's contributions to world peace. We place on record our admiration for his work and your work on tolerance, peace, and justice. For Belize, you are a particular inspiration since your model of seeking peaceful solutions to disputes instead of war and terrorism and vengeance resounds loudly with all the Belizean people. For many years, Belize has been engaged in a territorial dispute with our neighbor, Guatemala. And for the last 10 years, Belize and Guatemala has been engaged in trying to find a peaceful solution to this dispute. And while this attempt and the most recent of attempts has not been without incidents, it has been relatively peaceful. And so we thank the Ahmadiyya Muslim community for its leadership in peaceful resolutions, and we applaud your efforts and we salute you on this convention. On a final note, Mr. Chairman, more so out of an abundance of Belize's intention to associate ourselves with your principles of peace and tolerance, may I make a complaint that the Belizean national flag, I notice, is not flying outside. And it may well be because the Jamaat in Belize is relatively new, 2 years. But we do wish for that flag to be flown, and flown proudly in association with the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, because your principles are so very much in line with what it is we aspire towards in Belize. We congratulate you on this Jalsa Salana 2015, and we give you our deepest and best wishes on behalf of the government and people of Belize. Thank you.
I apologize that the flag of Belize is not outside. I promise to our honorable friend that we will either try and have it up before the end of this Jalsa, but certainly before the next Jalsa Salana, we will ensure that the flag of Belize is flying out with the rest of the flags there, inshallah. Our next speaker has come all the way from Canada, Mr. Jerry Savinos from Quebec, is a member of the National Assembly and also the Deputy Government House Leader. Jerry is a seasoned politician and is currently serving his fourth term in the National Assembly. He's an old friend of the Jamaat and a regular attendee of our community events. I welcome him to our Jalsa Salana and request him to come and say a few words.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Il me fait grand honneur d'être avec vous pour vous prononcer quelques paroles. Don't reach for your earpieces. I'm going to do the rest in English. But as a member of the government of Quebec, which has as its provincial official language the French language, it's my pride to be able to say some words to you in French before beginning my address. Dear friends, as the President and Chair mentioned, I am the Member of Parliament for Laurier-Dorion in Quebec and the Deputy Government House Leader. But I think it's important to mention that I'm here at the Jalsa Salana, not as a Member of Parliament, but as a friend and as a brother. Assalamu alaikum to you all. I began my relationship with the Ahmadiyya community in my local district in 2007. What I began to learn slowly and surely about your community are the exemplary values of peace, compassion, and solidarity, which are evident in all the actions of the local community and of the Jamaat around the world. I had the honor of participating at conventions in Canada. I had the honor of staying the entire 3 days because I felt it was important not only to address some words to you, but to sit down, exchange, and participate as much as possible in the conversations that strengthen interfaith understanding, cooperation, and solidarity. I had the honor of meeting His Holiness Mirza Masroor Ahmad in Toronto. And I must say that all these values are exemplified in a magnificent fashion by this great man who leads the community and who transfers and transmits this message around the world on your behalf. These values, of course, are evident in the work done by Humanity First everywhere around the world. And I remember the very first thing that struck me when I spoke to members of the Jamaat about Humanity First was that I was told, and it is clear, that compassionate help in times of disaster does not go only to those who share the faith, who share a certain nationality, who share certain views. But as its name attests, Humanity First, it is a gesture of compassion and humanity to those in need wherever disaster may occur, regardless of faith, regardless of opinions. And I think this is the clearest example, the clearest calling card of the community around the world, and I commend you for that work. I'd like to announce to you simply that I will have the honor today of presenting His Holiness with the Medal of the National Assembly of Quebec for his exemplary work around the world for the community, the Jamaat, and for the solidarity that he's exemplified in all his actions. Today, dear friends, we are going through difficult times, as some other speakers have alluded to. If ever we needed a strong Ahmadiyya community, a strong Ahmadiyya presence, a strong presence of Humanity First, it is today. So I thank you all for your participation. I commend the organizing committee, the volunteers, and all of you, and all the colleagues who've come from around the world to participate. May God bless you all. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you very much, Jerry. Our next respected speaker is a very good friend of the Jamaat. Muhammad Askar is member of the Welsh Assembly for South Wales East and is serving as the Shadow Minister for Equalities and Sports. Muhammad has been an Assembly member since 2007. His political interests include economic development and combating social exclusion. He joins us all the way from Wales. Muhammad is a passionate speaker for justice and has spoken at a number of events. Gives me great pleasure to welcome him back to our Jalsa Salana, and I request him to come and say a few words.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, and to all my brother and sister and distinguished guests, Assalamu Alaikum. This is actually, I'm going to give very short speech saying few words, but I'm going to steal from Qaid-e-Azam. He said in his three golden principles we all know, especially people from Indian continent, unity, faith, and discipline. My word, and by God, you are the one in the world who have actually adopted those three principles around the world, and you are the one are actually spreading the real Islam around the world to make sure that Islam is a peaceful religion and peaceful people around the world to make sure that we are the most sympathetic to humanity and the humanity and kindness to everybody. The love for all, hated for none is one of the slogans. After always I say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah is the biggest slogan you can ever think of. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, my friends. Actually, I come from Wales, which is a part of United Kingdom. There are four provinces, Northern Ireland, Scotland, Wales, and England. And what Ahmadiyya community is doing to the communities in this part of the world is incredible. We are doing annually thousands of pounds giving to the needies. Don't think that United Kingdom is the rich and the most powerful country in the world. Yes, it is, but there are still poor people. And Ahmadiyya community, in all under circumstances, are helping everyone, especially in Wales. And I can give you another good news. Very shortly, within a year, I hope, you will have a mosque in Cardiff, and your everybody in this congregation is welcome in Wales. And my friends, I only quote one thing to tell the world, of Muslim world, actually what they think about Ahmadiyya. It's not my word, it's the word from our God. Look at the Quran Pak. In a Quran Pak, it says, the person who is a tyrant, or a zalim, or kufr, I mean non-believers, they are the one going to go to the hell. Rest are all who are peaceful, honorable, justice, man, you know, cooperative, and understandable. They will never go for a wrong fate. And I can congratulate you all that you believe in the second bit. You are the best peaceful people in the world. You are the one who are actually spreading the real sense of Islam. In Pakistan, you know what is happening around the world in Islamic community. We are called on a very different label, but not many people know what is the Ahmadiyyas are. Ahmadiyyas are the most peaceful community in Muslim community, within the Muslim community. And you all should be proud of it. And Mr. Chairman, this is something, my hats off to everyone who comes here and actually shows the strength, unity, and the faith, which is Ahmadiyyat, is only 150 or less than 150 years old. But this tree has grown, and I can see the fruit, and I can see the people, I can see the young volunteers, and I can see the old people also. Not only following this, actually practicing Ahmadiyyat and showing the world, non-believers, that what really the Islam is. And I congratulate you all, and thank you again for coming to this annual Jalsa, and God bless you all, and God make this community grow every day and every hour, 7 days a week. God bless you all.
Before we invite our next respected speaker, we have a number of goodwill messages from various leaders, and I'd request Fareed Ahmed Sahib to read a couple of them.
Assalamu alaikum. We have a few messages of support from members of parliament in the UK, and I'm honored to read some of those. The first is from the Prime Minister, David Cameron, who says that he is pleased to send a message on the occasion of the Jalsa Salana, which will bring together the Ahmadiyya Muslim community for an annual gathering. It is heartening to know that the community comes together to promote collective values and becomes closer and stronger each year. This is a great thing to teach forthcoming generations. I do hope this year's convention is a successful one. Please accept my best wishes for the event. The Prime Minister, David Cameron. We also have a message from the Secretary of State for Communities, the Right Honourable Greg Clark, MP. He says, I warmly congratulate the Ahmadiyya Muslim Association on their many charitable works and their clear commitment to interfaith dialogue, tolerance and peace. I welcome your consistent support for British values and for working to maintain our shared British way of life. I am confident that the Ahmadiyya community will continue to make a positive, inspiring, and constructive contribution as the government takes steps to strengthen and celebrate our multiracial and multi-faith democracy. We also received a brief message from Cardinal Vincent Nichols, the Archbishop of Westminster of the Catholic Church, and he says, "I would like to say how much we appreciate the work and the friendship of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community in the UK. We wish you every blessing for this event and for your future plans and projects." We also have a message from the Mayor of London, Boris Johnson, who says, "I am delighted to send my best wishes once again to the Ahmadiyya Muslim community's annual convention. This has been an important year for community relations in London, and I know firsthand from my visits to Bethel Fathu Mosque in Morden and the great work you are doing for charities and individuals. Thank you for contributing in so many ways to promoting peace and tolerance in London and in bringing people together." Another Secretary of State, the Right Honourable Chris Grayling MP, also sends a message, and he says that, "I know the Jalsa is a key point in the calendar of your community. I did want to express my gratitude to His Holiness for all of the community's work and for the very positive and productive role you play in our national life, and for the very important work that you do to help those in need. I am proud to have many members of the community living in my constituency, and I have seen firsthand the important contribution they make to the work that the Ahmadiyya do in the United Kingdom." That's from the Right Honourable Chris Grayling, who's the Secretary of State for Justice. We have a further message from the Right Honourable Justine Greening MP, the Secretary of State for International Development, and she says, "I have the privilege to have the international headquarters of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community in my constituency. I'd like to pay tribute to the Ahmadiyya community, not just because it plays such an important role in Southfields in my own constituency, including the fantastic fundraising work of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Youth Association, but also because of the work that the community does around the world, not least through Humanity First. In my role as International Development Secretary, I know the challenges that we face to promote peace and stability around the world, and this is such an important event that brings so many people together to promote our common goals and focus on what binds us together. I wish you a very happy and peaceful Jalsa Salana." We also have a message from the former Attorney General in the UK, the Right Honourable Dominic Grieve QC MP, and he says, "I know that Jalsa is always an enjoyable and interesting occasion. It is also a celebration of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community's contribution to our national life in the United Kingdom. Over the years, I have got to know members of the community, and I have never ceased to be impressed by the levels of participation in cooperation with others of all faiths and of none in making our country a better place to live. It is a model of integration from which we can all learn. I very much hope that this year's Jalsa is a great success, and I would like to send all who attend from every part of the world the warmest welcome, and hope that this year's gathering will help contribute to the cause of peace for all." Another message from a Secretary of State for Health, the Right Honourable Jeremy Hunt MP, the MP for Farnham, reads as follows. "Over the many years I have known your community, I have remained deeply impressed by its unity and its genuine desire to do good to the world. Just two examples of this are the wonderful charity walks that you do that now have raised more than £2 million for British charities, and for the Muslims for Life campaign, encouraging blood donations, which save lives. I also want to pay special tribute to your work for human rights and peace. I know your community, under the wise leadership of His Holiness, is well regarded by many colleagues, and I will continue to support you and the good works that you do. Your message of love for all, hatred for none, is one that we should all aspire to." We also have a message from a local Member of Parliament, Zach Goldsmith MP, the Member of Parliament for Richmond, Park and North Kingston, and he writes, "To those who know the Ahmadiyya Islam, know it above all as a religion of peace, which has been at the vanguard of efforts to promote tolerance and respect around the world. Your founder and prophet, Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, famously said, "There are only two complete parts of faith. One is to love God, and the other is to love mankind to such a degree that you consider the suffering and the trials and tribulations of others as your own, and that you pray for them." When we consider the destruction of the Daesh in the Middle East and the menacing rise of religious extremism around the world, his message of not just tolerance but respect and empathy is one that we can all rally behind. 10 years ago, London also suffered considerable loss of life and the destruction at the hands of terrorists, showing that the challenge we face is a truly global one. His Holiness, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, also has worked tirelessly on spreading the message of peace, and I would like to pay tribute to his repeated condemnation of extremism, his advocacy of justice and compassion, and his spiritual leadership. As some of you may know, I am putting myself forward for the position of Mayor of London. London is the greatest city in the world because of its diversity, a home to people from every nation in the world, and because of its freedoms. I am very aware of the close ties between this great city and the Ahmadiyya faith. Not only were you among the first Muslims to arrive in the UK, your headquarters at the Fazl Mosque is the first purpose-built mosque in London, dating all the way back to 1926. What's more, being situated south of the river in SW18, it is close to my home community. That message is from Zach Goldsmith, MP. We also have a message from the Minister for Health, Jane Ellison, Member of Parliament for Battersea. And she says, "I was delighted to attend the charity walk at the Bethel Fathoo Mosque this year. And as Minister for Public Health, I cannot speak highly enough of the value of such events. Not only do they keep you healthy, but they are also an excellent way of raising the profile of the community, as well as raising funds for good causes. In this regard, I would like to pay tribute to your community members, young and old, men and women, in how they engage themselves in working for the common good. As a faith community, you exemplify the very best of your faith and also give a practical example of working for peace. Through charity walks and blood drives, the amazing work in bringing light and water and medical services to the developing world, you are saving lives and giving that most cherished gift of hope. I am proud of the work you do, and it is my wish that you continue to blaze a trail under the leadership of His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad." We also have a message from the chair of the Ahmadiyya Muslim All-Party Parliamentary Group, the Honourable Siobhan McDonough, MP, who is the Member of Parliament for Morden. She writes, "As chair of the Parliamentary Group for the Ahmadiyya Muslim Community, and as the Member of Parliament for Mitcham and Morden, where you have your stunning Bethel Fathoo Mosque, I wholeheartedly applaud your community's contribution in every sphere of life. Over the past few years, we have witnessed the terrible atrocities committed by the likes of ISIS that have shocked us all. I contrast the actions of those extremists to the wonderful work of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, and it is plain to see who stands for the true principles of Islam. Your community works for saving lives, for dialogue, for protecting the environment, for engaging youth in positive action, and for loyalty to your country. Your community is a shining example of what Islam stands for. Under the leadership of your Caliph, His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, you make a distinctive contribution to Britain and the world. His call for greater justice in the world and for greater compassion for all people is both timely and of great import as the world is facing increasing challenges. It is all the more remarkable when one considers that your community faces severe persecution, especially in Pakistan, and that there are many challenges in the world today, and I sincerely hope that your message of love for all, hatred for none, is heard by the world.